There's a nice bluegill on a slip bobber and a small piece of nightcrawler from 4 foot of water. Amazing the color on some of these good-eating fish. A good place to catch them is at the back of a quiet bay like this one. You can see where it's deeper back there because of the lack of lily pads. Also, there's a good growth of reeds along the shore. Add sand and gravel or maybe a beaver run or a dam and it gets even better back in there. Gills, as they are commonly called, will be more widely distributed throughout the various types of weeds than the more selective crappie. Bluegills spawn on the sand and gravel bottoms when the temperature is in the mid-70s, so they are going to be some of the last to spawn in the lake. They make a good food source for the earlier spawning walleye and northern pike. Don't worry about taking a limit of them because most of the fish that will be caught are males guarding the nest. So the females usually come in, lay their eggs, and leave. Sometimes to catch good panfish, you have to get way back in. Here we are going into a small lake through connecting waterway here, and the water temperature will heat up sooner back in the small bays and lake, so sometimes you have to go to the fish. Usually by the time the main lake is warm enough, most of the spawn is over, because the fish move to where they know warm water is the earliest in the year. So good luck fishing. Hope this helps you. 64-ounce jig and a little piece of night crawler is all you need.